First, ABC's Susan Solney has the latest on the investigation in New York and what police are saying may have led the gunman to open fire.
Today, attempts to tamp down the tension that has flared in the wake of the execution-style killing of two New York City police officers, even as departments and police unions around the country are on high alert and urging extra caution.
People need to make sure that when they go into law enforcement, they can depend on all of us to make what is inherently an unsafe job as safe as possible.
In New York City, anger, fueled by the belief Mayor Bill de Blasio and Attorney General Eric Holder haven't been supportive enough of police in the midst of national protests over the deaths of Eric Garner and Michael Brown. Police officers turning their backs to the mayor as he arrived at the hospital on the day of the shootings. New York City's top cop, Police Commissioner Bill Bratton, came to Mayor de Blasio's defense.
So this is a mayor that is really committed and gets very little credit for it to safety of officers.
Police say the ambush happened so fast, officers Wenjian Liu and Rafael Ramos never even saw their attacker coming. A man authorities have identified as 28-year-old Ishmael Brinsley.
Shot fired.
Police say Brinsley shot his ex-girlfriend in Baltimore before boarding a bus to New York, making clear his intentions with hashtags like shoot the police. SWAT teams chased Brinsley to the subway. Police say Brinsley, who had a long criminal history, ended his own life with a shot to the head. Last night, grief at a vigil for the slain officers. Police around the country are concerned about copycat attacks. The New York City police are already investigating more than a dozen threats. Susan Solney, ABC News, Washington.